They put me in the picture, but the film turned blue. A glimpse of you turning to tell me a handful of brand new words and a mouthful of shots. You're a big boy now with things to stop clocks. Turning to tell me, turning to tell me.
The two ugly sisters are going to be Maureen Connor and Janet Fraser.
Well, they won't need no makeup.
Cinderella. This was a close race between three or four girls, but Cinderella goes to Joanna Q.
Our Thomas.
Oh, she's black.
Have you put a bag of flowers?
And for those of you who feel it's important to distinguish between black and white, in our version, Cinderella is the adopted sister of those two ugly old monsters over there.
She's dead at police, honey.
What? Now then, the handsome prince. A very difficult decision again, and very much a late decision. This character has to be good-looking, debonair, able to dance, suave, pleasant, and charming. We really have to believe that he could simply sweep Cinderella off her feet. And with that in mind, I have decided on Toni Morris. The footmen are John Sloan and Paddy Lewis.
I didn't think it'd
Father
be him.
Is Kevin Donovan.
He's the last one over the pit.
The king is Tony Coates. The queen
just
because
he can dance, that's all it is.
Scully, I think you've got the hardest part, but I also think it's the best.
Yeah, I don't know. The glass slipper.
No, the fairy godmother.
What? You're not dressing me up in no shawl and high heels. Not to mention a pointed hat and a magic wand. That's not what I had in mind at all.
Well, what part was it you wanted, then?
Well, I thought it was going to be the prince. Well, I did.
Take it easy, Skull. It's early days yet.
You're not dressing me up as no woman, and that's that. I'd have to emigrate.
Just go through the script and look at the lines for now. Rehearsal will be 4 o'clock this afternoon, and don't worry.
It's true, though. I would have been a prince if I could dance. All the other bits were me. Hey, Morris, I'm going to learn all your lines and then break your legs just before the first night.
Come ahead, Mother. Let's get our script.
You better be home before midnight. I'm warning you.
So would you, from what I hear.
You're joking!
Hello, sweetie. I want 2 tickets for the front row, miss. I want to see his knickers.
Go and squeeze your pimples, you useless, slimy little boy.
Yes, miss.
You see what I mean? And this is only the start of it. I'm going to have more fights over this
Francis.
Than any...
Thank you.
I think not one of it. I don't. You could have told me.
Yeah, well, I worked on the principle that what you didn't know...
Till I found out.
And then it'd be too late.
It's not too late.
Yes, it is. You see, I've already kept my side of the bargain. I've got your trial game with Liverpool after school tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Night?
4 o'clock at the training ground.
Well, that was quick.
Yeah, well, I used to be a player myself. If an old player can't take advantage of one or two contacts he's still got in the game, who can?
Well, I'm not fit, Steve. I haven't trained. My boots are too small. Well, I wasn't expecting... so fast. I'm not making excuses.
Yeah, well, you might not need any. We'll see. This is what you wanted, isn't it?
I have watched over you from afar, my darling little Cinders. My darling little Cinders. Oh, can you see them now? Get them off, Skull. What are you doing after this show, honey?
Yo, listen to this. This is aces, this bit.
Hey, even if I do say so myself. Right, we're there with the old balls, right? Oh, don't say anything to Skull about this. He was dead jealous it was me. Nah, I don't want to upset him. Anyway, we're in the back kitchen. I'm organising getting the balls out the back when there's this knock on the door. Well, naturally, the other's bottles went straight off. They're all for diving out the back. Not me, nah. I took charge. I calmed everyone down. Strolled down the hall. Opened the door. Hey, and then, guess what, lads? Guess what?
There was a voice from the toilet saying you're a sodden, stinking liar, mad dog. Oh, Skull.
I didn't know you were there.
Yeah, well, go on, mad dog. You were at the door while I was in the kitchen being scared.
Well, sort of, well, it didn't quite happen like that. Actually, it was Skull at the door, not me.
What did you do that for? Well, why did you tell him it was you at the door? It was my big moment. I'd done something big. Yeah, but you didn't do it. I did. And I wanted to tell him something big I'd done, but I couldn't.
Why?
Because I couldn't.
What was it?
Nothing. I still think it was Sly doing that to me.
Ah, come on, mad dog.
Well, you can tell everyone it was you. I don't care. It's too late now.
Can I come to the ball with you to meet the prince?
You come to meet the ball and meet the prince? You're too ugly.
Far too ugly. And remember, tidy up before we come back from the ball, or we'll tell Father on you.
Again.
Oh, I am so sad. I so much wanted to meet the prince. Oh, at times it seems as though I haven't got a friend in the world. My goodness, who are you?
I'm your fairy godmother. Be afraid.
Oh, you see, fairy godmother. My two terrible stepsisters hate me very much, and they always tell lies about me. And they are so clever that my father believes them instead of me. They beat me and pinch me and laugh at me. And they are so, they're going to the ball to meet the prince, and they wouldn't let me go with them.
Oh, my dear.
Start again, please, Francis, from the beginning. It seems at
times...
It
wasn't that funny. It was only a little mistake. I don't know what you're laughing at me for.
We're not laughing at you, Francis. We're laughing with you.
Well, all I'm doing is watching it, and there's not one joke in it.
But it's as if you've studied someone doing just those things.
You're not right.
I know one thing. Kenny Dalglish wouldn't do this.
Who wouldn't? I'm your fairy godmother. Don't be afraid.
Listen, Mary, I've just remembered. I don't know how I forgot, really.
You can't come out tonight.
Yeah, look.
But you can and you're up.
No, listen.
Because if you don't, I'll make you the laughing stock of Liverpool.
I'm beginning to think I am already. There was a gang of lads that started shouting at me over.
Oh, I've heard them as well. I've heard them for years, little boys. Oh, and I was beginning to think you were a man. I have to tell everyone differently now, won't I? And then there's the robbery.
What robbery?
Oh, the one you and the dogs and my soft brother did last night. You wouldn't want that spread around now, would you, honey bunch?
It wasn't a robbery, but that's blackmail.
I know. I think it must be because I love you so much.
Look, you don't want to go on with me, Mary. I haven't even started shaving yet. My breath smells. Oh, But I've got pimples in unexpected places. I'm a fairy.
What?
In the school play. I don't know nothing. You know. Well, you know. About girls.
That's why I want to go out with you. I'll show you, Francis. I'll give you a good time.
Well, if you're going to put it like that, Mary.
Outside the bow and arrow. Don't be late.
Would there be a lot of people there?
I know.
Yes! Is it 7:30 already? Smart. I'll just get me coat.
Ow!
Hey, Francis. Don't be late.
Turning the town red. Turning the town red. Turning the town red. Turning the town red.
You lend us a couple of quid, ma'am?
Haven't got it, son. You'll have to borrow it from Mary Morgan.
Oh, they told you.
I think I read it in the Daily Mirror.
I don't use that. Can I keep nothing a secret? And I'm not, you know, going out with it. Anyway, Mooney will probably be coming with us. I don't look like that. He's got his heart set on it. But Mary, well, she's... He must have heard what they say about it.
Well, it doesn't matter what people say, son. Or what's said about them, it's what they do. I don't give a monkey's wrench what people say about me. Mary Morgan's probably exactly the same. And your mother, Maury. Rough as ourselves, but a lovely girl. Until she went mad. Nevertheless, remember what I always say to Tony? Be careful of Iapram. Oh, and by the way, Mrs. Bignall says you can borrow Brian's boots for your trial tomorrow.
Kenny, if you're there tomorrow, son, watch it out. Be prepared to be amazed. Who knows? Soon you might want me to be in your dreams. Picture today leaving Heathrow Airport for their honeymoon in Hawaii, Francis Scully of England and Liverpool fame, and his beautiful bride, Joanna. When asked, Joanna said, "We first fell in love when I saw Francis playing fairy godmother in Cinderella. He just waved his magic wand at me and that was that."
Oh, yeah. All right, Dad, how's it going?
There's a pound, son. Go on.
Now, if it's done that, I'd be having a nice house on night.
It's okay. It's no sweat. It's all right. Nice girl, Mary. And your mother. And have a good time. I did. Once.
See you, Dad. On time, I would think. It's a nice night, isn't it?
You mean there's nobody around?
No. Mild for the time of year, you know. Pleasant. Nothing's built to last these days, is it? $2 to what's due, please, pal.
Don't mess me about. I'm on the late shift. I'm in no mood.
Oh, look, I always have this problem, honest. I just look old for my age.
So does your mother over there.
That's not my mother. And don't you insult my younger sister.
25 pence each. Take it or leave it.
But look, I am a scholar. So she...
Told you, though. Ben's your friends here, because that's who told us. That's what friends are for, to let you down. Good old mad dog.
He should have been here himself. It was all planned.
Hey, you love Rotterspool, Mary. It's better than the cemetery.
Yeah. But Scully won't, because he wishes he was dead. Hang over, that's all I was telling you about, Mary. With the Liverpool Football Club.
Just think, when you're famous, I might be able to tell everyone that I knew you once, that we had a date.
Are you taking a Michael?
No. I won't even tell them that you tried to get scholars. No thanks. Well, didn't you know? Just given up.
Funny enough, I've more or less stopped myself with the...
Footballers shouldn't smoke.
Oh, no. Well, I had stopped, really. I just thought... cold all of a sudden, like it. Till it came off and me undies.
Oh, I really like you, you know, Francis. You make me laugh.
Oh, great. Go up with Jimmy Tarbuck then. Is that all I do, Mary? Make you laugh?
Oh, no. You have no idea. Oh, I bet you're really soft underneath it all, aren't you?
Those are compliments. I don't want to hear the insults.
Really gentle and generous and kind.
Oh, leave off, will you, Mary? You'll have to stop reading through romances. Wake up, will you? I'm not a doctor, and you're not a nurse. And I haven't just performed major surgery on your dad or your dog. I'll keep blowing my head off if you want.
And strong as well. Really, really strong.
Oh, yeah. You're getting a lot closer now.
Well, well, well. They said we'd find you here. The tea leaf and the bike. Like a fairy story. With an unhappy ending for you, Scully.
See, no notice, Mary. It's just another curtain couple. What was that for?
Because I've been wanting to do it for a long time and now I've got a reason. Get in the car, Plums. You're under arrest.
But what are you arresting me for?
For burglary, Scully. For burglary.
Why, you're making it up as you go along.
Oh, why? And I suppose I'm making up a portable television, a painting, three flying ducks and the contents of a fridge.
I didn't do that.
Oh, aye. Well, how is it your three little shite-hawk friends all confessed and your fingerprints is all over the house, eh? Eh?
Well, what about her?
Get in there. The bike. She can ride herself home. You were warned, Scully. I told you not to mess around with me. Nobody messes around with me.
The others made me go back, Skull. I didn't want to. All as I got was a tin of Spam. I wanted the ducks, but they wouldn't let me have them. This is, I don't like this kind of excitement, Skull.
Christ. The laughing policeman.
Soldiers and your mother's sleepers, turning the town red.